there's a young baby, unleash your cobra. I feel in your shots, yeah. 1 minute bang, get me sober.
That's Wendy, she's Uber driver here on Joy 99.7 FM. This is Drive Time on Joy with me, Lexus Vale. Yeah. Well, let me talk about Uber before I talk about Wendy, because Wendy is here. But you know, Uber is amazing. I love Uber. Yeah. Let me show you some of the benefits you get when you ride with Uber. Yeah. Quick time of arrival, usually between 2 to 5 minutes. Very reliable. There's safety features in the app as well. Like you can share your trip in real time with your family and friends. You can also see your driver or car details before arrival, which allows you to verify. Door-to-door pickup, which speaks to convenience. You request a ride when you need it. No need to schedule in advance, although the feature is available should you want it. The upfront fares, which eliminates the need to haggle, yeah. And you can pay either by card or cash. Affordability is always assured, so that's why you need to order an Uber. Yeah, makes riding around town really good. But if you want an Uber driver song, it's got to be Wendy Shay song, because Obia Peshe. What's up, Wendy? Finally, you're here.
Yeah.
Oh. I was about to roast somebody, but he's in the back, isn't he?
Yes, that's he's
okay.
In the back.
Good to have you finally. How you doing?
I'm good, and okay. I'm really feeling the Harmattan season.
Ah.
Yeah, because it's really working wonders in my throat.
Good or bad? Good or bad wonders? So we know whether we should pray or not.
Pray for me.
Okay, so Wendy, yeah. I want you to read the first message. The first message on the screen over there. What does the message say?
What do you think?
What do I think? Yes, I want you to read it out. Read it out.
Okay, she says, "Hey Wendy Shay, please don't ask her who she is."
And this is like the umpteenth person telling me not to ask you who you are.
Oh, okay.
So just for the record, I know you, okay? So I'm not going to ask you.
Like
this. But how are you? Congratulations. You've been amazing this year.
Yeah, thank you very much.
You're less than a year old in the entertainment industry.
Yes.
It's unbelievable, guys.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
Like you hear Wendy Shay and you think like she's been around for a long time. But it's less than a year.
Yeah, and I was never an underground artist or anything as such. I was a nurse and then now I'm a superstar. So
wow.
Yeah.
Mommy nurse. What about Panieda?
Of course.
Okay, so how did your last show go? I saw you perform at a church.
Yeah.
The gospel all-star concert.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it was an honor. It was an honor, definitely. I was there to support Prophet Samson Amwate.
Okay.
It was his birthday too.
Okay.
So yeah, definitely.
Good stuff.
Yeah.
Anyway, tell me generally, how has this few months' journey been?
Well, I'd say roller coaster has been very, very, I'll say, so many experience, lessons and blessings, I'll say.
Wow.
Yeah.
Lessons and blessings.
Yeah.
It's been very eventful. And like I said earlier,
definitely,
it's really amazing for a new artist to have this much publicity,
yeah,
you know, talk and vibe and good music and controversy and whatnot.
Yeah.
What has been the highest point of this journey for you?
Well, I would say that I'm always experiencing new stuff. And each and every time I go like, wow. So I cannot really pinpoint out which one is like the highest.
No. Think it through.
I really sat down and I'll say, okay, maybe dropping my first song, Uber Driver, ever, because it was really exciting. Because I've never dropped a song before, and my first song was a hit, so it was definitely.
So let me get this. You said you were a nurse, right?
Yeah.
You studied outside?
Yeah, that's where I lived. In Germany. That's where I grew up.
Okay, how long did
you live there still?
Oh, you still live in
Germany?
Yeah,
I still live in Germany.
So you come to do your
here.
Business
I'll
here.
Say I stay here, but I live there.
So you're a German Ghanaian?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
On paper too?
Yes.
Ah, okay. Yes. So you lived there for how long?
I grew up there, like, let's say from 13 till now.
From 13 till now?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
So high school?
Everything.
There. Qualified nurse?
Everything.
Did you practice?
I practiced for half a year or something.
For half a year.
Yeah, but then, you know, when you're in school, you also practice. So it was like more, yeah. So
yeah.
I used to work in a hospital as a midwife, actually.
As a midwife?
Yeah.
Was that like a childhood desire, something you wanted to do like all
like,
the time?
Okay, I already said I wanted to be a nurse because of my dad, because I lost my dad and to a very weird sickness, and my mom didn't know what that was. So because I wanted to know what killed him, I wanted to study.
So where did this music thing come in?
Well, I'm very musical. My family is very musical, and I went to a music school for 4.5 years, and I actually been singing in churches and all of that in music school too. I used to have gigs. So I knew I was going to be a musician, but never as a profession. I never had any contract with anybody. So Rafter Records is my first record deal.
So all you were doing, let's say a year ago, was being in the hospital, taking care of people,
being a translator at courts, because I have the benefit that I can speak 3 English and German. So I used to translate for, you know, Ghanaians who come there too.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
As a
part-time job.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
So to our German fans who are listening, you need to translate and tell them that we love them. Say
wir lieben euch so sehr und danke schön für den Support auch.
Au revoir.
Okay, bis dann.
Oh, that's interesting. But what's the most exciting part of your job as a nurse?
As a nurse, that I get to meet new people and that they trust me so fast because I get so close to them.
Mm.
You know, because as a nurse, you know, you wash them, you do everything with them. So yeah, it's really amazing.
What's your worst experience as a nurse?
Wow. I've got so many times.
Uh-huh.
Getting racist comments, like people some patients telling me not to touch them because I'm black.
Oh wow.
Yeah, I get those kind of approaches too.
And how do you react? What do
I mean,
you do?
I tell them that if they don't want my presence, I'll just leave. And in the end of the day, you're the one, you know, in bed, you need help. Mm-hmm. So if you're not nice to me and then you want me to leave, I just leave.
Wow.
Yeah.
That must have been really tough.
Yeah, but you know, as day goes by, you get used to that. So, yeah.
I see. Do you miss it?
Sometimes. I do miss, like, meeting the real good people. Because they really bless you, you know. Because I do what I do.
Do you recall any of those great experiences? One of them. Share one with us.
This man who I took care of before he died. Because I was working at a... when I was in school, I was working at... a ward that is where it's called palliative. I don't know how to say it in German, in English. Palliative, that is when people go when they're about to die.
Okay.
So I used to work there and I had to take care of this man, and he liked me so much and I liked him too. So we developed a great connection. Mm-hmm. And then he died, which was very hard for me because I really learned to, you know, separate work with relationship. Like, not relationship as in romantically, but then he was very old. He was like 70. So I saw him as my grandpa.
No, I do understand.
Do you get me? So when he died, I told him that I was going to see his body before. Like, it was kind of like a promise. And he gave me money. And so when the next day when I came and they told me he died, I knew he died because I could feel it when I was like, at home. I don't know. It was very weird that I knew he was going to die.
So there was
day.
Some sort of emotional connection with a man. Something,
I saw him as my grandpa because I love my grandpa so much too.
Right.
Yeah. So when he died and I really went there to see his body, I even touched him and all of that. And I could see he was very happy. Wherever he's going. Yeah. And he told me that he's really going to remember that he had a brown nurse that was taking care of him that he really liked so much wherever he goes.
That's cute.
Yeah.
Brown nurse. You can WhatsApp at 0244-340-437. I'm spending time with Wendy Shea here on Joy 99.7 FM. Mm-hmm. So now, along the line, music pops up. I want to know how it popped up. Did you reach out or did somebody reach out to you?
Jimmy Meeting Bullet.
Yeah.
Actually, you know, the funny thing is, I actually was, I went to The Voice of Germany and they took me. So I had to choose like between The Voice of Germany and Bullet. But then because I knew I wanted to do Afrobeat and I knew Ghana was the best place.
So you contested?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. And I kind of was part of those
the
who
finalists.
Qualified. Yeah.
Okay.
Those who qualified. So it was, I didn't have to think about signing with Bullet. I actually met him last year. At a concert in Kweu, and since I was an Ebony fan, I wanted to, you know, take a picture with Ebony, and that was when I met him and Ebony.
Oh,
for
you
the first time.
you met him and Ebony,
yeah,
and you wanted to take a picture with Ebony,
yeah.
Oh,
why not? Yeah.
That's in Kweu.
Yeah, Kweu Bliss on the Hills.
Right.
That was actually my uncle's. He does it every year.
Okay.
So I was part of the people organizing the show.
Right.
Yeah, exactly. And this year I'm part and he's paying me.
That's really
yeah,
awesome.
So that was how I actually met Bullet. But I got really introduced to him through a man I see as a father called Mr. Kwesi Ernest.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. So he took me to Bullet and he was like, this
so
is
at
my
that
daughter.
Point you had decided that you wanted to do
I
music.
Wanted to yeah, and okay. I knew I wanted to work with Bullet.
Why?
Because I think that I don't know, but for me, I thought he could, because of what he did to Ebony. Like, I saw how impressive. I really liked Ebony, so I wanted to, you know, be managed. I wanted to be managed by
you. Wanted to be under the tutor, you know,
under Raf tutelage
of
that was my dream.
Bullet.
Yeah, exactly. Because I could see, and thanks to him, now I can write like commercial music. I used to write like normal music, like soul, but since I got to Rafter, I can write commercial music as well, thanks to him.
Ah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, that's impressive. Wow. And this story actually started just last year.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Today you're like and playing big shows
exactly,
and whatnot.
Exactly. It's amazing. I thank God for that.
Okay. So when you, now you meet Bullet, you know, you have conversations about music and getting to do music, you're living in Germany and all. Was the plan to move? How convenient was it? How's the discussion? How did it
you
go?
You don't even know. I took the next plane and came to Ghana because I was like, that is what I want to do. I want to do music. And I knew I wanted to do that since I was a
kid. At what point did he agree to sign you on or probably
I actually sent my demo to Akwesianes, and he passed it on to Bullet. So when he heard my demo, he was like, okay, I want to work with this girl.
And was that last year or this year?
No, that was March this year.
That was this year?
Yes.
So that's actually after the passing of Ebony.
Yeah, but then I had already,
established contact.
Yeah, with him, yeah. So I was kind of there with Ebony. Ebony knew me too, so.
Oh,
yeah.
Ebony knew you as well?
Yeah, of course.
Ebony. Did you ever record or did you ever, spend time in the studio?
I wanted to, but it was too late.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So are you fully signed?
I'm fully signed.
What does the package come with? Well, apart from good hair.
I have a good management team. Yeah. They are there every time. Mm-hmm. I have bodyguards. I have security. Like everything, just everything an artist needs.
Mm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Are you happy?
I am. I cannot complain. Okay. Yeah.
Now there's a lot of buzz after Ebony's passing and brouhaha even before you came into the picture. Mm-hmm. Did that not scare you a little bit in any way?
Not at all.
Mm. What were you thinking when you were hearing all of those?
You know what I always say? Mm. I just say that, before a gold can shine, it has to pass through fire.
Yeah.
So before, like everybody's like, okay, Wendy Shay is the, whatever is the bomb and that. I have to, go through a lot of things. So I was ready for that.
Okay.
I knew I had to, everybody that was going to come after Ebony was going to be compared to her.
So you were ready for that?
I knew that. My management team also sat me down and were like, yo, this is the right way to go about this. Because this is, it's understandable.
Okay. So what do you say to people who say you're living Ebony's template?
I would not say that because definitely we are two different people. Mm. We have two different lifestyles. And
What's your lifestyle and what is Ebony's lifestyle?
I mean, or let's say brand.
Okay.
Brand, I'll say. Brand. Yeah, the brand.
No, but I preferred lifestyle.
No! I say brand because that is how people see me, Because Ebony was more like dance hall-like and I'm more Afro-pop, You know what I'm saying? Yeah, and besides, Ebony was a legend and she did good stuff. So if I'm even, if they say like, in tree, they say something, nipple, yeah, the papa, you know what I'm saying? So I don't see anything wrong for people to even say it's Ebony and when, but Edru baby, I need a trust because she is gone.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. She's gone, abandoned it, and already she's a legend. And I'm now, baby, at stage, I don't know, a pine, I feel I'm you, Drew. Show so boy in me afina me show. So you cannot compare a kindergarten person with somebody who is already like graduated. I understand them, but I don't take it personal.
Were you prepared for the criticism, the kind of controversy that you actually were ushered into the industry with?
I knew. About comparison, I'm tagging me as Ebony's replacement, right? But then in the end of the day, people are realizing that we are two different people. Mm. Exactly. Even from the background.
Which of the controversies really got to you? Did any of them get to you?
All controversies. What do you mean get to me?
I mean
there are some that like for example this picture that was going viral of me, they just took and all those kind of things,
right,
and planned that to do and whatever. It wasn't real. No, it wasn't.
So that's on your butts.
That's not my butt.
So your butts are fresher.
You want to see?
Yes. Guys, can you turn off the lights in here? We need to confirm.
Hey, Lexus.
We need to confirm if those butts. Because, I saw all that going around and I was like, man, this must be hard on you.
Yeah.
Have you broken down before in this period?
I wouldn't say broken. I'll say I've learned my lessons. Of course, definitely. I've learned a lot of lessons. And experience is the best teacher.
Mm.
Yeah.
Do you now feel accepted by Ghanaians?
I think gradually, I'm getting there. I have massive fan base now. Mm-hmm. And I'm just grateful. Yeah.
Interesting. Joy 99.7 FM. If you're just joining in, Wendy Shay is here. Having a good time with her. She's releasing her album in a few days. Right?
Yeah, on Thursday.
I shoot this girl, Charlie, it's some way.
It's some way.
Yeah, like it's unbelievable. When we need to document your journey.
Yeah, I definitely
You know what I mean? Because I don't think that any artist has had this spike ever in Ghana music like you have in six, seven, 8 months.
Yeah.
You are like the talk of town. Yeah. You are launching an album at Golden Tulip Hotel when on Thursday.
Yeah. And guess what? I'm even getting sponsored by Casa Precon. Like, and I'm a new artist. Like, it's so massive. I want to thank them so much because the support I'm getting from them is crazy. Wow. And access shipping too. I want to thank them so much. Like, really. I was about to speak German. Sorry. Yeah.
So tell me, what do you think has brought you here? What do you think has caused this sharp rise in your fame?
Definitely everything about Rough Town Records. Rough Town Records really pushed me and my hard work, and most of all, God, it's grace. I'll say it's grace because with hard work and all of that, and there is no favor or grace from God, I will make it.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Who chooses the kind of music you do? Who writes your lyrics for you?
Bullen and I.
Okay.
But Uber Drive and Bedroom Commando was written by him because that was my, I had to break through with some type of music. Yeah. But then the rest, we wrote it together.
Mm. I mean, we're not going to pretend that your music is not suggestive. all your songs are very suggestive.
Give me one.
Oh, really?
Yes, give me one.
Really?
Yes, give me one.
Hasta la vista.
Hasta la vista.
Bedroom commando. Bedroom bully. Hey, is it bully?
Hey, bedroom commando.
Bedroom commando. Uber driver.
Yeah, Uber driver.
Should we go on?
Yeah, go on.
What's the new one?
Massacre.
Massacre. Like, seriously? Now, is that you?
I'll say that is creativity.
Okay.
Yeah, that is creativity. It's how you take words, make it your own, and then project it out there for people to love it.
Okay.
Why are you laughing?
No, I'm laughing because of the message up there again.
Oh.
You see? See?
I get it.
So Millie says, Lexis, please, careful not to ask her who is Wendy Shay. Well, luckily, I've gotten to know her now.
Wow.
So I'm not going to ask her that. I'm going to read this message to you. Okay, listen to this. Lexis, she's very talented, but for me, until she apologizes to Miss G, I wouldn't support her musically. Note, I mean musically. We don't know the future, so I can't hate her, for we might do something in future. From Angelo.
Okay.
What do you want to say to Angelo?
I was on UTV today, and it's trending everywhere. I apologize to every Ghanaian or everybody that I hurt. Or broke his or her heart because of the statement that I made, and there is nothing.
Have you apologized to Miss G? She actually said Miss G.
Of course. Angela, if I say Ghanaians, then
no,
definitely.
They're two different things. Until she apologizes to Miss G.
But if I say Ghanaians, I say everybody that I hurt.
But you don't think it's worth a call to Miss G?
I mean, she's part of it, you know. If I say, I'm apologizing to everybody that I broke his or her heart.
You had the conversation with Ms. G.
She
you don't
is
think
then.
It's worth a
And I even said that there is nothing. I said there is nothing like a dumb question. I already made that statement. There is nothing called a dumb question. So, again, I'm sorry and forgive me for breaking your heart.
Okay. Lexis, good evening. I thought Ghanaians say Wendy Shay doesn't understand English and that she doesn't speak good English. Oh, really? Who said that? This is the first time I'm hearing that. But there she is. Your guess is as good as mine. Ghanaians don't celebrate the living, but the dead. Chris in Moscow. This is the first time I'm hearing somebody say you don't speak good English.
But
is that it?
But then I think he just said that, but there it is.
I'm saying, have you heard people say that you don't speak good English and whatnot? Have you been criticized for that?
I mean, even if I don't speak English, the last time I checked, English was in my mother tongue. Chi is my mother tongue. And I didn't grow up in an English-speaking country. And so, therefore, I think that I'm actually doing pretty good.
You are doing good. I'm surprised that anybody ever says that you're not good with the English. Anyway, a bit later, I'd activate the phone lines. You can call and have a conversation with Wendy. She has 5 tickets to her album launch at Golden Tulip Hotel this Friday. Is that it?
Yes,
I've got about 5 tickets. And if you're interested, you can call in and I'll give those tickets to you so you can be there, okay?
Joy 99.7 FM.
Now, Patrick from East Legon says, I really want to meet her up. I'm a performer. I'm hoping she can discover something good out of me. God bless Wendy Shay. Wow. She's at that stage already? Well, hi, girl. Just be focused on your dreams and forget about Ghanaians. They are like that. Everybody had worse critics than you. Vivian from Tema. I'm sure you also followed the story of Ebony and know all that she went through. Did it teach you anything, Doc?
I heard some, but I didn't hear all.
Okay.
I didn't hear all because I wasn't really active. I would say that I literally learned the positive stuff, definitely. I learned the positive stuff from her.
Mm. Yeah. How's your family also accepting, supporting?
My uncle, all my family members are Shay fans. They're like loyal Shay fans. My mom is Mama Shay. So yeah, definitely they're very supportive.
Okay, friends, everybody.
Everybody. My friends literally flew from Germany all the way. They are my house right now. They are trying to support me for my Shay concert to make it very nice.
Oh, so the German family is in here?
Yes.
For the big concert?
Yes, you have to come home.
So wait.
Why not?
When you stop that. Stop that. Now you caught me off guard.
Yeah. Wow.
Okay.
I did that.
Yeah, no problem. No. So Thursday we have the corporate launch.
Yes.
And then
the Sunday.
And then on Sunday.
That's when we have the tickets. So people can call in for tickets.
For the main concert.
I'm giving them tickets. Happening? The Shay concert.
Yeah.
Labadi Beach. From 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. And gate fee is just 20 cedis. But then if the callers call in, they're going to get some tickets for free.
Yeah.
I'm going to give them tickets.
Oh, good stuff. So 0302-216-541. You can feel free. Give us a call. Any question you want to ask Wendy, she's here. And if you want a ticket as well, we have about 5 tickets to give out for her concert. That's on Sunday. So feel free. Give us a call. Eunice is already here. Hello, Eunice.
Hello, Alexa.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing fine.
Nice. Can you speak up for me? Your voice is low, Eunice.
Oh, okay.
Nice.
Yeah.
So Wendy's here.
Yeah. I think I like the fact that she hasn't thrown her native language away.
Mm.
And she still has it. And it's excellent for others to learn.
Thank you.
And I would like to be at her lunch.
Oh, you'd like to be at a lunch, eh?
Thank you.
Okay, all right.
So then you get a ticket.
Stay tuned in and you'd get a ticket to be at her lunch, okay?
Yeah.
All right, Eunice. Thank you very much for calling in. 0302-216-541. Spending time with Wendy Shay and her Shay fans.
Yes.
Joy 99.7.
Lifetime on Joy with Lexis Bill.
I've got Stephen also on the line. Hello, Stephen.
Yeah.
Stephen, you're a little too happy. What's happening?
Hey, nice to you.
Hey, what's up, bro? How are you?
Got a long time. Where you go?
I turn around small.
Really?
Yes.
But you didn't tell us.
Oh, forgive me, bro.
So I have to play the track you always play.
Which are the songs?
Nelly and Jahim.
Oh, my place?
Yes, remind myself of you on radio.
I hear you. I'm going to do that. Okay, talk to us.
When you say?
Yes, what's up, Steve?
What's up?
Chale Adeo.
Oh.
Are you coming to my concert?
Yeah.
You want to come?
Yeah.
Okay, so where are we having the concert? If you get it, you're going to get a ticket.
You just go into the right?
That is the lunch, but the concert itself.
Whoa.
Oh, it's at Labadi Beach. La Pleasure. La Pleasure Beach.
Yeah.
It's fine. You're still going to get the ticket.
I'll pass by Joy.
Okay. So please leave your number and your name so that they can get that to you. Yes.
Let me say what I have to say.
Okay.
You know, in Brandon,
in sorry?
If you are selling the product, okay?
Okay.
Now, the people who are patronizing the music have a perception of you.
Okay.
As in, you are trying to be in the mode of Ebony.
Okay.
What you need to do is to establish a brand.
Okay.
That really distinguishes yourself from Ebony's brand.
Okay.
When you do that,
mm-hmm.
the customers, who are the people listening to your music, who patronize your concerts, all the things that you want to do, will know that you are not Ebony.
Mm-hmm.
Asking okay. questions on whether you are Ebony look alike and saying you are different, it's just for you to see, but in reality, is that what it is? So, mm-hmm. customer perception is very important in branding.
Okay.
Yeah.
Why, Stephen, you don't think she has been able to convince you she's not Ebony enough?
So, this song called Yepotea, sorry.
Mm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
It's similar to Ebony's song that she did it in the marketplace.
But, you know, similar is similar to same, but not same as same.
Yeah, I get what you're trying to say. I get you.
I understand that. I understand what I'm saying, that for us as customers, that's mm-hmm. our perception of mm. you.
Okay.
What you need to do is to deviate from what we think you are to something different.
Okay.
But Stephen.
Yes.
She said that, you know, Ebony was good. We loved her. She was creative. She had some really amazing stuff. So if she's like her, what's wrong with that?
Okay, no, it's not okay, if wait, she wait, is wait, like her. Uh-huh. I wanted to clear something up.
Yes, Stephen.
Leslie, hello. Leslie.
Go ahead, Stephen.
Ebony was a bad girl in that coat. You understand?
90s bad girl.
Yes. And when they say is being coached to be a bad girl, which she's not. She's not. She knows. You are not a bad girl.
Okay.
You are not.
No, okay, let me clear something up. You know, are you there?
I'm here.
Okay, I want to clear something up. You realize that Bullet is the one that wrote all of Ebony's songs. You know that?
I know that.
Yeah, so if he is my songwriter, what do you think?
I understand that. I'm saying that Ebony.
So that means that we will say that Rough Town is doing everything then.
I understand. I'm saying that Ebony, you know, was in that mood. It was, a round peg in a round hole.
Yeah,
okay?
But Stephen, do you have a problem with that? Do you have a problem with that kind of brand? Don't you enjoy the music?
I do, except that she must be different. That's all I'm saying.
Well, but if but how would you? And then it's not even about that. I mean, the way there are so many stuff that differentiates.
But Wendy,
yes,
Wendy,
I can. Yes,
Wendy,
I'm listening.
You are not a bad girl, okay? So don't try.
Well, how would you know? How would you know I'm a good or bad girl?
When I see someone's a bad girl, I know. And those who are being coached to be bad, I know.
Okay.
Stephen, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Great talking to you. Hey, boy. Are you a bad girl?
I'll say that I'm a very versatile and flexible artist. I'm an artist of what weather. So if I'm supposed to sing gospel, I'll try and find my way. And if I'm supposed to be
small question,
I'm trying to give you.
Okay, so yeah, I'll decide to send us a message in German.
Yeah,
Wendy, over to you.
Vorlesen. Okay, also,
what did he say?
Wie geht's mit, also, actually, he made a mistake. In welchem Krankenhaus haben Sie gearbeitet? Dein Song mit Kam Eugene ist nett. Ach, danke schön. He asked me how I'm doing and which hospital I work in, and my song with Kam Eugene is very nice.
Okay,
that's what he said.
So answer him.
Yeah, also zuletzt habe ich als wie heißt es, Hebamme habe ich dann beim Marienhospital gearbeitet in Stuttgart.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ich würde davon tosset ab da. Hutet ab so a joy. 99. Which war Hartung. 0.7. Okay. So there have been conversations about the Music Awards as well. In fact, I've heard. Let me get this last caller before I get in there. Hello.
Yeah, hello, like this.
Yes, dear. What's your name?
Abina.
Abina, talk to me.
Yeah. Hi, Wendy.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Hi, dear.
Yes. Hi. Ghanaians appreciate whatever you're doing. And in a way, I kind of agree with the previous caller, Steven.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, because we see more of Ebony in you than Wendy Shay.
Okay.
So even if Bullet is the one writing the song for you,
mm-hmm.
you can add your own thing.
And which I do.
Yes, because there was a time you came to the ANC Mall with Bullet. Yeah, okay. I was around.
Okay.
And everybody could tell you were not comfortable in what you were wearing.
Which one?
If,
okay.
So the time you came wearing this black short, was it a skirt or a short? You're not comfortable.
But
I think Bullet is trying to push you, like...
No, I think like, you are maybe getting it wrong. Because nobody...
You have the talent.
Uh-huh.
You have the talent and everything.
Yeah.
Let us love you for who you are.
Yeah, but that is me. Because, I cannot be anybody for so long. I mean, wouldn't it be so fake? And mind you, I grew up in Germany, so wearing such stuff is like very, like, you know...
Around, we saw you were not comfortable in what you're wearing. And on Saturday, I had to watch you on Music.
Yeah.
And when, like the guy said, Yakoti Asori song, I could, if I close my eyes, it's like Ebony singing.
Okay.
Yes.
Because I wrote that. Mm-hmm.
Like, do a different thing. Let us accept you for who you are. Let
well, then I'm going to dare you to buy me to buy my album, because then you're going to see different varieties of me and different sides. Because on my album, I have High Life, I have Soul Music and everything there. So probably you can have other sides of Wendy Shay too. What do you think?
Okay, then we are patiently waiting for the album.
Thank you, girl.
My dear, so I'm just wondering. hello, are you there?
Yeah, hello. Yeah, I'm here.
So I'm just wondering, are you? Do you have a problem if she sounds like Ebony, or she, does everything like Ebony?
Yes, I do, because it's just like you trying to replace her. There's an issue here. The girl is dead and gone. Let her rest in peace. I don't know why Bullet is trying to. Get another Ebony.
I don't really think that Bullet is trying to get another Ebony.
Wouldn't you rather...
For you, you don't see it that way. But to us, like the guy said, it's Brandon. That is how we see it. That is how we see it. You have the talent.
Mm-hmm.
But turn it into, like, make it your own.
Okay. Well,
thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank
okay.
you for your opinion. Thanks.
Now, let's talk about... making money, because that's the whole idea, of course,
making
right?
Moves, making shrimp.
Making money, yeah, getting criticized and all. It's all about making money, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So, are you making money?
Of course, I'm making money.
More money than you were as a nurse?
Yes, definitely. Yeah, that's why I actually mainly quit my job, because I want to do so much for my country, and just being a nurse won't be enough. Yeah.
So now we can confidently say that it's over for you when it comes to nursing.
How about me building hospitals with my money and getting nurses and teaching them with the knowledge that I have? I think that is much better.
Okay.
Yes.
Oh, good stuff. Well,
thank you.
Wendy Shay on Joy 99.7 FM.
Time Wendy on the beat. Fantastic Louis V Gucci bag, no synthetic. There might be a peshe, hey, send me to one or more shit. Kufu a peshe, even Nanado so peshe. Hey, Mahama peshe, baby just bullet so peshe. I say media, yes, it's him. Washa Linda, Asha Diana, Carolina, Rosalinda, Uber driver, what it's your matter, thoughts to watch out. There might be a peshe, hey, send me trim one or more shit. Kufu a peshe, even Nanado so peshe. Hey, Mahama peshe, baby just bullet so peshe. My
So a bit later this Thursday, she officially launches her album at Golden Tulip Hotel. I'll give you more details. And she has a concert as well at La Pleasure Beach that I'll be talking about here on Joy 99.7 FM. Lots of your messages coming in. Wendy Shay is really hot. I see lots of people really excited and concerned about her. Well, interesting. She's loving it. She's living it. She's enjoying it. Derek in Texas says, I wedged the damn question. I know they come. Lexus, check fast. Why? Probably after the news. Let's think about it. I just need to be sure she's not going to say cat, cat, cat. I don't do this interview again. Yeah, I need to be sure. Anyway, stay tuned in.
You're welcome to the headline news at 5 with me, Ernest Mina. Former President John Mahama says he's learnt his lesson from the defeat in the 2016 elections. Addressing the media and party faithful at the Trade Fair Center a while ago, the former president said his decision to contest the flag bearership race and subsequently the 2020 general elections was after broad consultations. He promised to work hard to justify the confidence placed in him so far.
I did not make the decision to enter the contest in isolation. I consulted broadly with all levels of our party, from the grassroots who are our lifeblood to the elders on whose shoulders I stand. I sought the wisdom of our chiefs and the counsel of our political religious leaders. They all did me the courtesy of offering me frank, constructive critique of my own strengths and my past shortcomings, as well as those of my administration and our party as a whole. Yet, I also truly respect and equally appreciate the views of those who, whether in the public space or in private conversations, express some misgivings about my decision to re-enter the political contest. I wish for all such persons to know that their advice was not lost on me, and that I indeed intend to prove myself worthy of their confidence and to assuage their fears in the months ahead.
And you have the former President Mahama. Now the First Lady Rebecca Akufo-Addo says she'll work to ensure the elimination of malnutrition in Africa, especially in Ghana. She said this at the 2018 African Nutrition Championships, where she was named the Nutrition Champion for Ghana. Mrs. Akufo-Addo pledged to employ creative and ingenious strategies to achieve the ultimate goal of proper nutrition for Africa.
Working with the Kufuor Foundation, the African Leaders for Nutrition Initiative and other stakeholders, I hope to employ creative and ingenious strategies to achieve the ultimate goal of entrenching proper nutrition in Africa.
And you have the First Lady Rebecca Akufo-Addo. Now, Parliament Roads and Transport Committee is accusing the DVLA of charging customers premium service for the processing of driver's license without parliamentary approval. The premium service delivers license in less than 30 minutes, the first in Ghana's history. The minority wants the DVLA to get the parliamentary approval for those charges. Kwame Aduda is minority spokesperson on the Roads and Transport Committee.
The DVLA was going to work together with the Finance Ministry to ensure that what they intend to charge is captured and we all can move on. It is not an attempt to make anybody look like doing the wrong thing. Indeed, they are charging a prestige fee which has never been charged. That is a fact.
And that's Minority Spokesperson on the Roads and Transport Committee, Kwame Adboja. A midwife at the Tamale Teaching Hospital detained a mother after delivery because she could not pay a fee of 32 cedis. Now, this and many more are some stories shared by patients at the facility on extortion by some nurses and doctors there. Here are excerpts of a documentary, Robin the Sick, produced by Kwetinate.
I meet this lady. I've decided to call her Zina. Her sister was detained at the maternity ward. The midwife who delivered her of her baby is demanding money for assisting her during the delivery. This midwife is popularly called Auntie B.
Yes, she has to pay the money. It's meant for drugs that we use to induce her pregnancy. That's why you're paying 32 Ghana cedis. If it wasn't for the drugs, she would have paid 20 Ghana cedis. Then we also delivered her of her baby, and she has to pay for that.
Well, the PRO for the Tamale Teaching Hospital, Dr. Ken Osemensa, has been defending some of the monies demanded by the health officials.
And some people feel that because of the national health insurance, when they are not supposed to pay any amount of money. And I understand that this particular one that the lady was demanding monies for is misoprostol, that's Cytotec. And even though we are not condoning this practice, that woman, that night, saved a woman's life with that drug.
Now, the full documentary airs on the Johnny's channel on Multi TV at 8:30 p.m. And just before we go, British Prime Minister Theresa May says the UK will vote on the Brexit deal this week, beginning 14 January. Now, the vote was due to be held last week, but was put on hold after Theresa May admitted she was set to lose. Announcing a new date, Mrs. May said the EU had made it clear the Irish backstop was, quote, not a plot to trap the UK, and urged MPs to see Brexit through. Labour has threatened to force a confidence vote in the PM if she did not set a date for the vote. And that's it for the headline news at 5. We're back at 5:30 with Top Story.
Joy 99.7 FM.
Dashing to pay bills is a thing of the past. International remittance can be sent now to your phone. Send cash easily, make payments easily. What fun it is to use Momo with MTN each day. Hey, Momo bells, Momo bells, Momo.
Brogna, Brogna. MTN Momo, Ebemo Utumayo de this season. Send 200 CDs or more to other MTN Momo users. Nakosua receive international remittances using your MTN Momo and get rewarded with 60 minutes, 1 hour free airtime instantly this Christmas season with MTN. I can teach you, Brunya Pa. Make a house say MTN Momo no Aisekut, a chino atayibia niho. Just Momo it everywhere you go. Brunya, Brunya.
Hello, Daddy.
Hello, Mommy. Have you received the money?
Yes.
Okay, hang up, let me call you.
No, Daddy. Please stay on, let's talk. I have enough phone credits and data. We can talk and chat. Guess what, Daddy? Uh-huh. I went to collect the money you sent at GCB, and they gave me mobile credits, which I am using to call you now.
Really?
Yes, Daddy. They are also giving out shopping vouchers, fashionable wax prints, and more. Daddy, please send me my school fees now. Because I have targeted more gifts. GCB is in partnership with over 10 money transfer companies, so no need to worry about the money transfer company. This Christmas will be mega with a GCB Xmas Plus promo.
From now till 31st December 2018, redeem your international remittances from any GCB branch and get your reward. Note, the higher the amount, the bigger your reward. Terms and conditions apply. GCB, your bank for life.
Pulse Fitness Ghana is 5 years already? Hip hip hooray! Join us in celebrating 5 wonderful years of championing fitness solution in Ghana. From the 19th to the 30th of November 2018, we are organizing a fitness competition for all our cherished clients, DAP, Mr. and Mrs. Pulse for clients below 40 years, King and Queen of Pulse for clients above 40 years. Activities include weightlifting, calisthenics, and endurance. Who will be crowned Mr. and Mrs. Pulse and King and Queen of Pulse? We crown our celebration with a fun walk to Ibri on the 7th of December 2018 for the whole of Ghana. Come and let's train for fun. So come and support us make our 5-year celebration a success. Pulse Fitness, at the heart of fitness.
F-Pak is effective for headaches and relieves the symptoms of flu, colds, and catarrh. F-Pak blows away the pain associated with sore throats. During and after a hard day's work, F-Pak relieves you of body pains. After the day's sports workout, F-Pak helps the body to control the aching muscles. F-Pak is effective against feverishness. F-Pak reduces body temperature associated with malaria and other fevers. F-Pak is effective against rheumatic pains. You can find F-Pak in all pharmacy and chemical select shops throughout the country. F-Pak is not recommended for children less than 16 years of age, ulcer and asthmatic patients, pregnant and lactating mothers. If symptoms persist for more than 2 days, consult your doctor. F-Pak blows your pain away.
F-Pak
FPAC Junior follows in the tradition of FPAC tablets, a trusted friend to relieve your child of pain associated with teething, catarrh, cold and fever. The good that FPAC does for you, FPAC Junior does for your child. FPAC Junior is for children between 6 months and 12 years. FPAC Junior blows your child's pain away.
Home sweet home. Welcome, girl.
Wow.
What a stylish sofa.
Oh, my God.
Oh, girls, you haven't seen anything yet.
Really?
You should go to the Ashram showroom. You'll be blown away.
Exquisite
sofas like the 7-seater Sankofa, L-shaped MFA, a 6-seater Akoma, 7-seater Ohima, and many more. And as I sat in one of the sofas, oh, my goodness, I could feel myself literally dissolve into the softness. And guess what? I said there's no way I'm not getting one for myself.
I know, right?
Visit their showrooms in all the big malls and other locations near you and enjoy free delivery to your doorstep. Call 0243-200-729 or 0248-00-5300. Ashfob. Feel it, know it.
Move on up, 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 up.
Moving on up is paying from your phone and getting looks of approval from your friends. Moving on up is doing all your banking from your bathroom like a boss. Moving on up is losing your wallet, but your money is still safe. Moving on up is attaching any bank's card to the EcoBank mobile app. Oh yeah, download the EcoBank mobile app. Make we go and bank like a boss.
Move on up with EcoBank, the Pan-African bank.
Darling.
Spill it.
You know, I promised to go appliance shopping this Christmas, and I'm here to tell you that Samsung is making this possible with the Samsung Blue Christmas promotion. Rush them now, or I'm taking the kids to my mom's for Christmas because grandma only uses Samsung appliances. Thanks for your cooperation, signed, the kids and I.
Hey, wait for me, I'm coming.
Make your home the best holiday spot this Christmas in the Samsung Blue Christmas promotion. Samsung has the best discounts on appliances and free gifts for you and the family. When you visit any Samsung showroom or authorized reseller, it will be simply magical. Buy a 32-inch satellite TV and get a free wall bracket. Entertainment will come alive when you buy a 49 or 55-inch TV with a free DSTV Zapper decoder. Chill drinks? No problem. Fridges start from 899 Ghana cedis. Washing machines starting from 999 Ghana cedis. And so many freebies for you when you join the Samsung Blue Christmas promotion this Christmas season. Make this Christmas a memorable Blue Christmas with Samsung. Merry Samsung Blue Christmas!
Hey, Charlie, coming here was stood up by some lady.
No, Charlie. That wasn't how it happened. She invited me to a place, sent me an address, and I drove over. I didn't even know that was part of Accra. It was deserted.
Charlie, what was the girl's house then?
Oh, it was a prank. The girl gave him a wrong address. To make matters worse, my car wouldn't start.
So how did you get to?
Charlie, Ubao. I was far out in the city, and I still found one. Cheers to that.
Request a ride with Uber in Accra at any time, and get to your destination with convenience. Uber, where to?
In everybody's eyes, the Mensas are different. It is not because of how loudly Grandpa Mensa boasts. It is not because of how Mrs. Mensa is making big plans to open a new shop. It is not because Mr. Mensa's son has a list of fantastic dreams. It is not because Mr. Mensa is always giving great advice. But it is because Mr. Mensa took a My Life insurance policy for his family so that they can feel free to live the life they want. Be a hero to your family. My Life, live more.
Call My Life on 0242-439-999.
We say there is never a dull moment at Melcom. Actress Melcom be bia hobe kwa wogana faneng inano. Unya niya upe, ane bota form na usai sivi sikaso. Geng in actress eh, Melcom dunku mi ateso is back. And this time, it's bigger than ever. Anyo, afidye eche kanenu mpo. Enjoy amazing discount on thousands of items. Actress bunya nube yeda, esha se fwisi siya. Bra, Melcom, neba tonyo ma yatisu. Wede yatisu say fufufufufufu. No that you save more anytime you purchase from any of our branches nationwide.
Terms and conditions apply.
Malcolm, we're Ghana shops. Malcolm, don't call me. Yateso. Yateso. Don't call me.
Get ready for the most hilarious night of your life. The night of 1,025 laughs and music.
And you know, I do tell people sometimes, we most of what is our gather, you buy VIP ticket, VVIP ticket.
to sit at the front. I want to ask a question. If I crack joke now, are you the first hearer?
The night of 1025 laughs and music. Boxing Day, December 26th at the Conference Center. On stage, Bovi, Kenny Black, Sheila, Aquaruru, Jacinta, Foster Romanos, Lexi the Comic, James Brown, plus performances from Kitty and Joe Metal. Get your tickets now from Charterhouse, X-Men and Nalam stores in Osu, Accra and Junction Malls for only 200 Ghana Cedis Standard, 300 Ghana Cedis Premium and 400 Ghana Cedis VIP. The night of 1025 laughs and music is supported by Marriott Hotel, Japan Motors and Joy FM.
That's Wendy on Joy 99.7 FM. Now, what do you enjoy most about using the internet? Is it the hilarious videos, those funny memes and pictures, comments, messenger, or simply staying in touch with your friends? Well, guess what? You can enjoy 50 megabytes worth of free data to browse your favorite sites everywhere you go. Yeah, simply call your loved ones. You only pay for the first minute of your call on MTN free after one, and the rest of your call is free, absolutely. And then you also enjoy free 50 megabyte data to browse your favorite sites. So dial *315# to sign up now. Terms and conditions apply. Yeah. Your living room deserves class, some warmth, and a haven for all. Yeah, friends and family must enjoy a comfortable and serene atmosphere right there in your home. And that's why Ashfoam has produced sofas and couches to fit in every corner and space of your home. Ashfoam Ghana, the home of comfort, brings to you the choicest of designed sofas, couches, tables, bows, chairs, you name it. For your poolside, your balcony, or garden area, our sofas are crafted to offer support for your spine when you sit to relax your nerves. So visit our showrooms across the country and delight yourself with Ashfoam exquisite living room furniture, including the 7-seater Jinyame, the 7-seater Sankofa, the L-shaped MFA, the MFA Deluxe, 6-seater Akoma, 7-seater Ohima, Fafali, and the Reina couch. You can also add to the beauty of your garden, balcony, or poolside with our rattan chairs. Our sofas are of high quality, durable, and affordable. They come in different colors of upholstery and quality leather. You can call 0243-200-729 or 0248-005-300. We do free delivery to your doorstep. Be an Ashfoam now. Ashfoam. Feel it, know it. What else? One D shame.
Lexus.
Yeah. Let's go to church.
Yes. You know, see my journey. So why are you counting my money? In Ghana, when God bless you, then they try them my best to kill you. Why you want me to die? You don't know, say I'll be God's child. Ready, miss your rewards. I want you, my own people. Miss Rewo, miss Ufrewo, miss Rewo.
That's right.
Deliver me from danger.
Psalm 35.
God bless you, then they try them my best to kill you.
Oh.
Hmm. Why you want me to die? You don't know, say I'll be God's child. Ready, Mr. Rawas, I want Jimmy, I'm making
Oh, Wendy, Omunkun, what's it? It's Romunkun. Why? Psalm 35, Wendy Shade. So, interestingly, your manager, Bullet, called and said that he wants to have a word with us. Oh. So, Bullet is not lying. Hello, Bullet.
Hello.
Boss.
Hello.
Boss.
Yes.
Hey, Bullet, how you doing, man?
Hey, like this.
How you doing, Bullet? I know you're busy. Putting together the launch of her album on Thursday and all, but you made time to listen to the conversation and you wanted to say something, isn't it?
Oh yeah, I was just enjoying the convo and everything, and the interview. I mean, like,
that's right.
That's an amazing interview. And I wanted to clear some things, you know, because I think most of the listeners were saying when she sounds or eternal, live in the shadows of Ebony, but I want to make something clear. Like the way record labels operate or the way we do our stuff is different. Sometimes, you know, what we do is, let's say Rough Time Records, what we do is like we even make artists sing songs. We want to make money, okay?
Uh-huh.
So we even make artists sing songs that they don't even believe in sometimes. The reason why I'm saying that, everybody is talking about hustle. I wrote Hustle. I wrote and composed it. And it's a rough town something. Like, it's this Bullet style. Because when I even met Ebony didn't have that style. They're so rare.
Okay.
He's a very brilliant singer. But it's Bullet.
So
whole thing is Bullet. You understand?
If I'm getting you right, you are trying to say it's deliberate.
It's deliberate. I know what I'm doing.
So you
I know what I'm doing.
So you have deliberately decided to make her live, you know, or sound in a certain way.
It's not sound. It's like it's a rough town style.
That's the rough town style.
Yeah, it's a rough town style, and that's what we create the music. You understand? And let me give you an example. Let's say if we take Legacy Bear from Joy FM to Adum FM. And no matter what, they will know this. And I bet it's on. Hello?
I'm listening.
Say a foul free, Joy, Echo Adoma. He'll be one of this Legacy Bill.
Yeah.
Even though you are transmitting a different frequency, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, the song, let's say, the Massacre song, it's a rough town record song, you understand?
Okay. So.
And if you take Alomo Bites and you put it in a Coke bottle, it's gonna taste Alomo still. So when you say it's unique in her own way, you understand? When you listen to the album, it's 10-piece album, when you listen to the album, you see different types and different styles.
Okay.
Of when
I think you're trying to say that it's a house style that you decided to make her fit in.
It's a rough town style. I can take anybody, I can even take you, or if I write song for you, you might have the traces of maybe the Ebony style because I wrote everything.
Okay, Bullet, you know what? This is quite delicate, and I like how you are trying to explain it. And from the business perspective, it's beautiful. Unfortunately, we don't have so much time. So why don't we have this conversation on Monday, okay? Next week, Monday, why don't you come over to the studio? Let's have a session, just you and I. We can have a conversation. And, you get to get us to understand the rough town style and get some more conversation going. What do you think about that?
All right, so maybe I need to be in the studio and explain it to listeners.
Exactly, exactly.
Wendy Shay is very talented.
Yeah.
She's different and she's versatile. But
okay.
We choose this time, this is the kind of song that Rough Time want to bring it out.
So Bullet, let's do this on Monday. Next week,
I'm writing most of the hit songs with her.
Right.
You understand? Yeah.
Okay. So it means that, I mean, I didn't want to push this further. I wanted us to have a sit down so that you can explain all of these things for people to understand. And I'm sure you're trying to get people to appreciate who Wendy Shay is and also the house style of Rough Town Records. So I'm saying that on Monday next week, come on my Behind the Fame segment. Okay.
All right. No problem.
Deal.
No problem.
All right. So I'll see you on Monday and then we can talk some more about it. Because if it's a house style, people need to also understand that. Because, for example, there's so much similarity when it comes to even Ebony's Hustle song and your new song, Massacre.
Yeah.
When it comes to the video, I think Ebony did hers in the market. You also did yours in the market.
No, I didn't do mine in the market.
Well, it has some.
It was in front of a church or something.
Or some
like
little. Okay, well.
Yeah, but it wasn't.
But the look and feel kind of has. Yeah.
Because, you know,
similar.
And we did something to, you know, match the festive season. I mean, you know, you see bandsmen playing. That is very, you know, Christmas like. That was why we did that.
Okay.
Exactly.
I see. Danny Beats. Joy 99.7 FM.
Massacre, oh massacre, Wendy massacre. Because you're young, you're my pebble man, you're na mene na bumu na ya kotia sorry, nti ya kotia sorry, yo ya kotia sorry, ya kotia sorry, a fade massacre, nti ya kotia sorry, yo ya kotia sorry, ya kotia sorry, a fade massacre, miss you, demon by boy, di mam by boy. Odi mam pai boyo, a mama de me ho miss you. Odi mam pai boyo, odi mam pai boyo, odi mam pai boyo, a mama de me ho.
Pacho Presbyana Catholic. Hey,
I sorry na yatinu.
What is it? Somebody
now I saw you demo master. Me from Osha.
The Osha.
I wear Osha. From
German girls no bad.
No
baby Atma.
No.
That's right. Well, it's that time you've been waiting for as well. The Joy FM Keteke Fever is on. Omanya Hall, Labadi Beach Hotel. Wednesday, 26th of December, Boxing Day, 9 p.m. It's going to be something else. Best disco mixes and great dance moves from the 70s and 80s. Tickets for 150 Ghana cedis at the front desk of Joy FM. You can call 0540-106-466. You can't miss it. This Saturday, we're live. What are you doing on Saturday, Wendy?
Saturday.
When's your concert again?
It's on the 23rd. That is on Sunday at the La Pleasure Beach.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
so Saturday, what are you be doing? Relaxing?
Saturday,
and
no, I'll be rehearsing. I need to rehearse because it's my own concert. It's
but the German girls, what are they be doing?
They are dancers too, so I'll be dancing with them.
Oh, okay. I wanted to invite them to a party, you know. So after their rehearsal.
So then, until they come, so which one? So we all come
party,
together.
Party the park. Yeah. So this one is a garden party,
oh,
you know,
okay,
in the park,
it,
you know. It's not indoors.
I get it.
Don't worry.
Hey, Lexus.
Yeah, sorry.
Hey, Lexus.
Sure, the Joy FM family party in the park is going to be something else this Saturday. Come through. It's a family time. Bring the whole family along. Mom, dads, the little ones as well. For a refreshing, fun-filled day. It's 25 Ghana cedis for a family of six. Come over. We're going to give you Joy FM branded Christmas hats. Looking forward to that. It's proudly brought to you by Wilma Africa Limited, manufacturers of fried tall, cholesterol-free oil and importers of Fortune Rice. And First National Bank. Yeah.
And Lexus, you know what? On the 23rd, when they come, they are going to get free Casa Proco 10 over 10. That is a soft drink. They're going to get it.
Oh.
Yeah.
So everybody gets a bottle.
That's
nice.
Yeah.
Exactly. That's really cool. Thanks to Casa Preco. They're making it big. I love that.
Yes, they're really supportive. And access shipping too. Like, I really want to thank them.
Well, good stuff. Well, we're going to come there and support you on 20th and 23rd, right? 23rd is the big concert at La Pleasure Beach.
Yeah.
And how much is it?
20 cedis.
20 CDs.
Yes.
Oh, that's...
Yeah, that's quite cheap.
Right? But that's your big concert. It should be like hundreds.
Oh, no. I mean, let's come and have fun, you know
okay,
what I'm saying?
Okay, sure, cool. Yeah. 20 CDs, everybody. We're going to be there at La Pleasure Beach to support Wendy Shea as she releases her new album. What's it going to be called?
Shea on You.
Shea on You.
Yeah. Shea, as in Wendy Shea. Shea on You. Yeah.
You want to say shame on you?
No, no, no. I want to say shame on you. Like, you guys have to deal with me. I'm in your faces. I'm on you.
Thanks a lot, Wendy. Great talking to you. Sure, and God bless you. God bless the journey.
Yeah,
good
thank
luck
you
with
very
it.
Much. Thank you for having me here.
Love too much.
Thank you.
If you want to bank the smart way and earn unbeatable commission, you can always bank with Bank of Africa. If you're a salaried worker, make sure you route your salary through Bank of Africa. You would earn interest up to 3% as commission on your average balance.
Yeah.
For more details on how to participate, visit any Bank of Africa branch or you can call 0302-429-333. Bank of Africa, bank smart, earn more. My name is Lexis Bale. Thanks a lot. To my team as well, Adam Naite, Philip Naya, Abeku San Kofi, and Selwyn Ofori. Coming up, it's Top Story with Evans Mensah. I'm back tomorrow at 2 o'clock with Drive Time on Joy.